Welcome to For the First Time in Forever, the show that aims to fill the gaps in all of our watch lists. Last week we took a look at William Friedkin's horror masterpiece, The Exorcist, and if you haven't seen that, you can check it out by clicking the link in the description below. But this week it is time to delve into a film I have been aching to see for ages. So, are you watching closely? This is The Prestige. Wait a second. I am going to be talking about spoilers for this film, so consider this your warning now.
What you're about to see is considered safe.
With the release of TENET now upon us, I took it as an opportunity to delve into the work of Christopher Nolan as anticipation. I myself confess Nolan fanboy, so it wasn't exactly hard for me to do that, but The Prestige was always a film that I just never got round to seeing until now. Set in the late 1800s, The Prestige is the story of two magicians, played by Christian Bale and Hugh Jackman. Initially friends and workmates, they soon morph into enemies after an unfortunate accident during a trick. Their rivalry starts out as nothing more than sabotaging each other's performances, but after Bale's character reveals a trick that defies anything seen before, it sends Jackman on a dangerous spiral to uncover all the secrets that lie within. Now, with it being a Nolan film, of course, things are never as straightforward as they seem. Once again, he tells the story through a somewhat time-jumping narrative. It's far more conventional than his earlier works in Following and Memento, but there are three separate timelines running parallel, with no indication of when the story is jumping forward or backwards. And that's perhaps what I love most about Nolan's work. He never, ever treats his audience like idiots. There are too many times nowadays with blockbusters that spoon-feed the audience exposition and never allow them to actually think for themselves. Nolan's films require his audience to use their brains, so as long as you apply yourself, you will be rewarded. The three timelines running throughout The Prestige all eventually convene to, at the end of the day, have a completed narrative. The first timeline we encounter is that of Alfred, having been arrested for the murder of Robert and awaiting to be sentenced. Then we skip back in time to show how this rivalry began and its immediate ramifications. Meanwhile, we also cut slightly forward in time, but not as far as Alfred in jail, with Robert investigating the teleporting man trick, leading him to meet Nikola Tesla. And as we go along, these three timelines are cutting in and out of one another, feeding the plot prior to the scenes and just expanding our understanding of how this film is basically going along. To put it into a more linear fashion, once you strip the bravado away, The Prestige is basically a film about two men and their eccentric egos in an effort to better one another, having been fueled by revenge and jealousy. In the case of Hugh Jackman's character, he is harboring resentment for Alfred's carelessness leading to his wife's death. Thus, he seeks to sabotage Alfred's career and diminish his success as punishment. However, this passion for revenge quickly transforms into an obsession when he witnesses a trick in which Alfred teleports from one side of the stage to the other in an instant. With the aid of Jackman on top form, the addiction his character is beginning to be consumed by is enthralling. At points, it walks very finely on that line where the notion of revenge is forgotten, and he is in almost admiration of the trick. But as the story continues, the obsession becomes too much, and our perception of his character quickly changes. He starts the film as the potential protagonist, but by the end of the film, as Robert has cracked the secret and is dispensing his clones and plotting to destroy Alfred altogether, the temptation of power, knowledge, and control has made him into a far more unpredictable character. As for Alfred, I found him to be absolutely fascinating. At the start of the film, this is a man who simply sought to bring something new to the table. Then, rather adhering to the whims of what the crowd want, he looks to the medium of magic and creates something the likes of which they haven't seen before. And ultimately, this leads him to a troublesome path, where he begins to experiment with a revolutionary new technique. What is this technique? Well, And I believe this is where it might lose some people. It's cloning. To complete the teleporting man trick, Bale clones himself. Now, I have conned on that Fowler, Alfred's aide in the film, was far more mysterious than the film was letting on, having only seen glimpses of his face and having little to no dialogue. But the revelation of Bale and his clone having toyed with Jackman and created this master plan where they would trade lives in an effort to constantly dupe and deceive those around him is a brilliant stroke by Nolan. And this is where The Prestige pulls off its most incredible feat. Once you form the narrative into a linear structure and the penny finally drops as to what Nolan is trying to do here, you realize that the way in which his story has been structured is identical to the structure of a magic trick. At the opening of the film, Michael Caine outlines the three acts to a magic trick. The first is the pledge, where the magician shows you something normal, something ordinary. In the case of the film, it's the fractured relationship between Alfred and Robert, driven by jealousy and grief. The second act is the turn, a moment in which that ordinary thing has been turned into something extraordinary. Nolan does this through the teleporting man trick. We saw Alfred execute it to an almost seamless degree, that it being a double was out of the question. It's a feat that goes beyond a performance or a mere trick. It's real magic. And then the final act, the prestige. Bringing that thing back, the grand reveal, but still adhering to not reveal all of the secrets. Now, in terms of the story, part of that mystery is lifted. The revelation of Bale having a double that has been with him the entire time, and how the act of two people leading one life leads to the double sacrifice to ensure that the real original Alfred can live and remain with his daughter. But Nolan's ambition is greater than that. The prestige is about the reveal, but not the secrets. We still don't know how this cloning procedure really works, but as Bale mentions earlier,
never show anyone. They'll beg you and they'll flatter you for the secret, but as soon as you give it up, you'll be nothing to them.
Now, that's not to say that this film is without its flaws. A continuing downfall in Nolan's work are the presentation of female characters. More often than not in his films, they usually adopt the stereotype of a damsel in distress, or they are just merely playing second fiddle to the needs of the leading man. And unfortunately, it's no different for The Prestige. Rebecca Hall plays Alfred's wife, who remains stuck at home in a slowly declining marriage as Arthur begins to lose his grip on distinguishing performance from reality. Scarlett Johansson also appears as the glamorous assistant to both Robert and Alfred, who eventually serves as a love interest to both. But given the level of depth to Alfred and Robert, these two female characters, who are being played by more than capable actresses, are provided with very surface-level motivations. The pacing itself is also quite gradual. Like all good magic tricks, there needs to be a sufficient build. The atmosphere needs to be constructed. The stage needs to be set. But there were quite a few occasions where I feel as if the film goes off on too much of a tangent. But then I suppose, just like a magic trick, there needs to be a suitable amount of misdirection. It's one of the main fundamental laws of magic. And so some of those moments that you could perceive as tangents are nothing more than purposeful red herrings. They are deliberately meant to deceive us. The best way to experience The Prestige is to treat it like a magic trick. Nolan is the magician, and this film is his grandiose illusion. His writing and directing is second to none to craft a story that is wholly original and stupendously captivating. Christian Bale and Hugh Jackman give fantastic performances, but once again, it is that sublime story structure for The Prestige that at the end of the day, it makes you ask that all-important question. How did they do it? So, after watching The Prestige for the first time in forever, it is well and truly God tier. Anyway, guys, those were my thoughts on The Prestige. Let me know, have you seen the film and what did you think about it? Also, are there any other films on your immediate watch list that you are yet to get round to seeing? Just to give you a few updates for the channel, we are currently in the midst of a Christopher Nolan extravaganza with the release of Tenet, obviously being out in the UK. You can expect a Christopher Nolan edition of Ranked coming very soon, as well as, when I get around to it, a Christopher Nolan fan edit that I'm really, really excited about. Also, usually for this series, I look to have a guest on for the first episode of every month. Unfortunately, for this coming month, it's not going to quite work out. There are too many scheduling conflicts. I've got to focus about work as well. So, didn't quite pan out this time, but well and truly, we will be back with a special guest come October. But anyway, it will be business as usual. So, here is what you can look forward to next week. Thanks for watching. If you have enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more, please make sure that you click that like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. All the links to my social media accounts, my Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and my letterbox are all in the description below. And if you haven't liked the video, what are you still doing here?